Down! Neutral, neutral.
Flash of leg kicks early on. Four ounce gloves, knees, elbows, all the good stuff here. High check there from Janet. Wearing her traditional gold and burgundy trunks. The black and silver on the Norwegian Hogstad. Hogstad coming off that career high performance against Alma Uniku in Manila. Nice check to the inside leg kick there from Anne Line Hogstad. Janet really is a volume fighter. Once she gets flowing with the hands, with the legs, she's very hard to stop. Nice cutting side kick, skipped into it there, did Anne Line Hogstad. You'll see the difference in a Muay Thai stance as opposed to a traditional boxing stance or a kickboxing stance, in that the gloves and the arms are turned out rather than facing each other. To be able to better catch the kicks with the double forearms, to also catch the elbows.
Yeah, Michael, it's interesting that you say that, because the hand positioning of Anne Line is kind of like in a triangle. And Janet Todd told me earlier this week that there's a giant hole right down the middle of that guard, and she expects to utilize it by just using the straight punches, especially the one and the two, to just touch up the face of Anne Line.
Fakes and feints outside leg kick there from Janet Todd. Anne Line gloves up very high. Janet rides that outside leg kick. Anne Line wants control, center circle, try and press the world's kickboxing champion to the outside. High kick there from the Norwegians. Flurry of punches from the American, Janet Todd. Gotta say, Mitch, in my overall opinion, when it comes to both kickboxing and Muay Thai, Janet Todd is the best put together female on the planet right now.
She's remarkable in a lot of areas, but she's also tremendously fast. She does everything with such speed and accuracy. And that's gonna be a problem for Anne Line. She's gotta slow her down. She's gotta start utilizing her best weapon, which is that. It's that right kick. She needs to throw it often, and she needs to attack the body, the legs, and the head of JT. Because right now, you can just see JT is operating at a slightly higher pace. Everything from JT is coming off faster.
Yeah, she just threw that inside leg kick there and then moved completely out of the way. Not just leaned back like a typical Thai fighter would, but moved completely out of the way before Hogstad was even able to counter with her kick.
A real joust in the opening round here between JT Genetod and Anne Line Hogstad. You saw Todd go to work with the elbows in the opening round. Usually, though, it's what Anne Line Hogstad prefers. Excellent crossing elbows, especially from the clinch. We saw that in the third round against Alma Uniku. Nice gazelle punch there.
You know, Mitch mentioned before the match here that what Hogstad needed to do was make this an ugly match, like get on the inside, utilize those elbows and knees, just like she did against Alma Uniku. But she's not. She's been standing on the outside trying to play the same game that Todd is good at and Todd is faster at.
But it's hard to get in tight when you have shots coming right down the middle. It's gonna disrupt your ability to close that range and enter into the clinch. So Janet's able to do that. Look at that. Went up high, distracted with the hook, and then came right down the middle with the one and the two. She's got incredibly fast hands. Anne Line needs to make this ugly. Start touching up her with that right kick, do damage with the legs. She's trying, but Janet's just a bit too fast.
The way that Janet Todd is able to read the incoming attacks is just superb. Her reflexes, her vision. High right roundhouse kick just tucks it under the left arm of Anne Line Hogstad. The number two versus the number three ranked women's Muay Thai, Atomweight. And of course, Janet Todd, the one Atomweight kickboxing world champion against a two-time ISKA Muay Thai world champion.
Janet used the word fluid when she wanted to describe how she wanted to be in this matchup. And she's kind of showcasing that. She's trying to find this flow to her, just her rhythm and her state. And we're starting to see that come out.
Probing jab from Annaline, uppercut there from Janet Todd. 1-5 remains, second of three. Nice extension on the front kick off the back leg there from Janet. Annaline with the round kick, not enough pivot on the lead foot though. Got to turn the hips over. Try to loop the shin around the back of the neck. A little more pivot on that one.
Annalina, who has the height advantage, but it seems like Janet Todd's the one that's fighting like the longer athlete.
Janet smiling at her, enjoying herself, also playing mind games with Hogstad, trying to get inside the Shield Maiden's head and frustrate her. Any advantage you can get in this game, beautiful combination work again from Todd, then drifts off to her left to get out of the way of any counters.
Yeah, Hogstad's just playing in this range. She's got to make this decision. She needs to move forward. Whether or not she can actually beat Janet Todd on the inside is a different story, but that is the only way she's going to end up getting it done. Is she just needs to, if I was in her corner, I'd be like, walk forward, walk forward, walk forward, close this distance, make this thing ugly.
Fake the high kick, went downstairs, did Annaline Hogstad. Nice inside thigh kick to that femoral profunda. Seems to be all for Annaline Hogstad to do in the third and final round. Beautiful three-punch combination there from Janet, goes down the center. Step across inside thigh kick from Janet, then goes to the outside leg. Jab two round kick from Annaline Hogstad. Left hook, little quarter turn from Janet. Again, turns with that lead hand. Front kick to the chest there from JT. Annaline thought about skipping in and just got picked off wonderfully. Beautiful anticipation on that front kick. As you said in the previous round, Rich, Annaline is in that proverbial no man's land. She's too far out to do any damage. She's not even close enough to work the clinch, and she's getting picked off on by Janet Todd.
Absolutely. You see her in this range, and you'll see her step forward like that kick right there. That Janet Todd doesn't respect that kick, and she doesn't have to respect that kick. There's no power to that. And so she needs to either step in and actually throw that thing or stay out of that range because she's just allowing Todd to just pick her apart.
Oh, oh, body shot beautifully done, folds her in half like origami.
I love the liver kicks.
Hey, look at me.
It impacts the vagus nerve. It closes.